again yesterday. I'm teaching more Chinese words. This is the writing brush. See, you can see it's like this, a lot of folds, and then I dip in the ink. Let me show you. This is the ink, Yidege ink. Too much. Probably too much here. Because it can. And then we dip. Use this. Use this. This is called a platform, as I mentioned the last time. As I mentioned, the ink will go through the paper. Leave on the table, so I put one here to as a cushion in case they will the ink will make the table dirty. Now let's begin. Here's here. Oh. Like this. This is a book. In Chinese, we say shu. Now, let me write it. The Chinese pinyin is shu. Like this. Shu. This is the Chinese character shu. This is Chinese pinyin. Shu. U, wu, wu, wu. Full sound. So this is the first sound. So we use the small slash. Small hyphen. Shu. Let me read the English. It's called a book. Shu book. This is a book. 这是一本书. We put here. This we put here in case the ink goes through there. Usually we put books in a bookshelf. Bookshelf in Chinese we call it 书架. You know, a shelf, we put a lot of books there. Let me write it. Shuja, where we put the books there. Chinese pinyin says shuja. Shuja. Chinese pinyin 书架. It's similar. It's the same as the English letter, so it's easy for you to see. Yeah, SHU, just the, yeah, there are extra small hyphen. And then this one's 架, G, like Jack in Jack. I, like in India. And then A, and then, yeah, there are extra, yeah, you know, sign to, how to say, mark the pronunciation, because we have full sound, yeah. 架, 书架. Let me read the English. Here. Oh, it went in the bag. The ink, so it affects my writing, so I reread it. Like this, 书架. 书架。Bookshelf. Shuja, bookshelf. Let me put on the bookshelf so you can see. You can remember. It's the bookshelf. So now I put the word here. Shuja. So you know, Bookshelf, Shuja. Bookshelf.This is a book. 书 Let me put it here. 书架 This is a bookshelf. These are books. These books is called 书 S-H-U 书 Book. This bookshelfcalled 书架书架 bookshelf. Okay, let's continue. Let me write more. I see my fitness ball. So let me write the ball. Fitness ball called 健身球 Just the ball we call the 球汽油球 the ball like a gym ball gym ball so we call them 健身球 Let me write it I shake it before I use it. Yes. Like this. In case I put too much. See? I already read it. Jian means fitness. Jian Shen Jian Shen Jian is like a fitness. Shen is body. We get our body fit. Fit. Qiu when I picked up the ink, like a movie, so I will show you later. 健身球。击案件，健身。We can call it a fitness ball or gym ball. See? 健身球，健身球 ，gym ball. I have a gym ball there, so I put there so you can, yeah, remember clearly, yeah, what it is. This is a fitness ball.This is gym ball. 这是一个健身球。这是一个健身球。Gym ball. Now I see the light. Floor light. So I will write that down. Floor light. Yeah, I have floor light here too.落 is floor length. Floor length. Luo di deng. This is the Chinese pinyin. You probably know. Yeah. The letters is the same. It's the same as the English letters. Just that they have the extra pronunciation sign. Yeah. This is the first one. This is the second one. Luo di deng. Floor lamp. Now I saw the dump bag. So yeah, in Chinese it's called the ya ling. I will write that, and then I will put on top of the dumbbell, so you know it's called ya ling. Ya, 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 ling. This is the third sound. Long time I didn't use the Chinese pinyin, I almost forget. So sometimes I have to rethink how the word, how to read them, how to do the pinyin. And yeah, I try to make sure the pinyin is all correct. Yeah, ling. Yeah, ling. Campbell. Okay, see, this is called the ya ling, second sound, ya, ya ling, 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 ya ling, ya, and it's a spell like this, ya, y, a, and the third sound, ya, ling, I-L-N-G, ya ling, dumbbell, dumbbell, it's ya ling. Yeah, I have two small ones. Yeah, I put there so you know it's ya ling. All right. Yes, ya ling, 健身球. 落地灯, 书架, 书, floor lamp. This is a floor lamp. 落地灯. This is the second sound. 窝窝, 落窝, 落窝. 落地灯, 落地灯, floor lamp. Okay, let me recap what we learned today. First, we learned book, book, 书, 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 the first sound, 书. Second, we learned 书架, bookshelf, bookshelf, 书架, 书架, bookshelf. And then we learned this 健身球, 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 gym ball. Gym ball. Jian Shen Chiu, gym ball. And then, Luo Di Deng. In Chinese, we say, Jie Shi Yi Zhan, Luo Di Deng. Luo Di Deng. Luo Di Deng. This is a Chinese pinyin. Floor lamp. And then, last we learned. The dumbbell. The dumbbell called ya ling. Ya, ya ling. The third sound. Ya ling. Dumbbell. Dumbbell. Ya ling. Okay. Okay, so yeah, my hand is still hurting, so I cannot write very well. So I think I may wait after my hand recovered. I can write more. So for now, today, yeah, I just teach these some five words or the words bonding together. 书, 书架, 健身球, 落地灯, 哑铃. It's the things we see every day, pretty much, right? When you think about that, you can remember how it looks like the word. And the next time you can recognize the Chinese character and probably also the Chinese pinyin. All right, see you next time. Thank you for watching.